to carry the team. And they're both out here in the semifinals before our best player skipped up.
He's 3 for 4 in the line. He's found the first one. Second one, no good. So he's 2 for 4 so far today.
That's the thing about he does shoot a lot of three pointers because he shoots a lot of three pointers. And you're not going to get to the line that much when you shoot three pointers. But when you score it like a team,
score. Just 1 out of 3 at the line for the Cougars. So the score is 14-10, 4-point lead for the Cougars. Under 13 minutes to play now. Here's Egan, and it's the point guard responsibility. Drops it off baseline now for Patrick Britton. Britton up top. He picked up assist. 3-pointer on the way. Then the corner up here. Lafayette working against Slogan, drives, drops it off, but he was fouled before him.
Yeah, Lafayette was coming out more offensive than tonight. Last night, the Giants had a shot from
7-3, 2-4, in the second versus the Rice.
Rice substitution, number 21, Rodney Foster, replacing Corey Flager.
Rodney Foster has come back into the game, replacing Corey Flager for the Owls. McKeever bounces it into Thorpe. He steps in, gets it back. Now he's double teamed, but finds Lafayette. He's swinging all the way around the ring. Now back to time to go to D.A. Marcus Columbia won a point on the goal. He runs the baseline. Malone drives. The runner off the glass. Good shot from the left hand. Oh, now we're going to get a whistle and a foul on Hagan. It hit McKeever and Oscar for the action. They bumped a little bit. They bumped into each other, and McKeever acted like he took a shot to the face and went back, and he drew the call from Tom O'Neill.
Yeah, you're right. He had these laughs, and he knew he pulled one off that time.
Now McKeever got him good there, and they get an offensive foul call on Hagan. Well, Hagan now has two, and Houston gets the ball back, leading by 3. Standing good right now by Malone. 15 to shoot. Sends it far side to Lafayette. Well behind the arc. Back to Malone. On the inside, Dow in the corner. Dow behind 3, 1 dribble. 10 to shoot. Here's Malone. Good crossover dribble. Pulls up. Off the glass. No good. Long rebound. Thorpe has it for Houston. Here's McKeever. Baseline jumper on the way. No, but a foul. Dow with 2 points. Punches it through.
From the top of the key to follow that up if you don't win. That was just a great play offensive rebound.
Dow with 3 points. The lead is up to 5. Good defense again by Malone to get a hand in the face of Morris Harmon.
They made every shot that Harmon was taking so far.
Here's McKeever. Free throw line jumper comes up short. Thorpe had the rebound, knocked away. Knocked away again. Now finally picked up by Lafayette. In the lane, back out to McKeever. McKeever off the dribble double team. They're going to set it with Malone at the center circle.
You got 2 minute scores from Austin. I don't think that many second shots. I think that's a very good defensive play.
Lafayette for 3. No good off the heel of the rim. Long rebound to McKeever there.
That's the fourth shot of Mr. Jefferson.
Now Malone finds Thorpe. His little short jumper will not go. Rebound to Rice this time. As quickly into the front court is Hagan. Almond on the baseline left side. Had it poked away out of bounds. Too late. On the floor. Action. 18-13. Houston on top by 5. 10:09 to go first half.
Thank you.
support out of the city of Houston, split their head-to-head meetings in the cross-town rivalry, as in the first meeting of the year back on January 17th, Rice won 76-71. They had to overcome a 24-point. Then on January 31st, 2 weeks later, it was Houston with the victory at home over Rice, 70-63. Almano held to 21. McKeever had 21. From the field. Rice in that second game to 6 of 15 at the free throw line, which really killed them.
Yeah, both these teams, they played each other very well. They're very good with each other. So whenever they play, we expect to get better. So far tonight, Houston's got off to a better start.
10 and 9 to go, 18-13. Houston with the advantage. Rice with the ball.
Rice posted Almond up that time, and he was the one to kick it out for the free throw. So looks like they're going to move him around. And he'll be in the round. That's a good start to the song, right? That's interesting with the number 10 goals that Houston likes. The Rice to play them in the game.
Inside, goes to throw back out. Good skip pass down in the corner. Dial for three. No. A little bit too strong. Rims out. And the rebound pulled out of there. That's Chris. Charles Beckton. He's been a freshman. 6'4 freshman out of Fairborn, Georgia. He's in the game for the first time.
Great ball made by Houston. Wide open shot. Good knock down. That's what he's doing.
Lorenzo Jordan. He's too fast. Into the corner. Great team. Belton. Going to shoot. Williams drives.
Malone was so concerned about Omni. He turned his back to the offensive guy and let him go wide open. He should have turned around and either draw the charge or maybe try to foul him. He has to lead the basket.
5 quick points out of the timeout for Rice. So it's a tie to their team. McKeever, left corner to Lafayette, looking inside, nothing there. We get a whistle, foul off the ball. It's an offensive foul on Jamal Court of Houston. And the second team foul against Houston, first on court. 25 to go first half. We're tied at 18. Winner to take on Memphis tomorrow morning at 10:35 in the championship game. Malone now with two fouls, and he will go to the bench. So now let's see who guards on. As in to replace Malone is Robert Reed, 6'3", 197-pound junior. And he's got the assignment.
He's getting made about 3 or 4 inches on him. Let's see if they lost the whole thing.
They post up instead with Patrick Britton. This shot comes up well. Possession when we come back. First the timeout. 7:50 minutes to play. First down. Houston 18. Rice 18. This happened to us in semifinal game. We're coming back right after this. Sun Sports 56.
Memphis Convention Visitors Bureau. FedEx Forum. Tiger Sports Properties. Marriott Montana. Nike. Pepsi Bottle. Little Chase Toyota. Fast Signs. Pizza Meta. And in this year's championship host, the University of Memphis. We'll be right back.
come through for it, though.
Right now, you've got Rice shooting 53%. Houston just 33%. Houston is 4 of 7 at the line, while Rice has not been to the line yet. And also turnovers, 5 for Rice, just 2 for Houston. And Houston has created 7 points off those turnovers. Rice has got the score off of the Houston turnover. Here's Allman from long range, comes up short. He has about 30 feet, and off the up there's the rebound.
Yeah, he was again. He was recognized. He's got a smaller guy on him, and he doesn't.
McKeever bounces to Thorpe. Thorpe guarded by Allman. Thorpe going to work against him. Time drive shot, no good. Good defense. And that's the thing about Allman. He can guard, too. He's not a bad defensive player at all.
Yeah, he's a totally right complete player. That was great defense.
That was great defense. Offensive rebound, man. Houston gets the second back down. Here's McKeever with the screen from Thorpe. McKeever right in lane. Picks out for Lee. Three ball from Lee. No good. Rebound. Oh, and he's fouled. He's got 4 rebounds and 1 assist to go with his 2 points so far. He's 4th in the league in rebounding at 6.5 a game, so you forget all the other things, and he's a good rebounder too. Williams trying to bounce it inside for Britton. Knocked away by Houston as Dowell came from behind and knocked it away. Out of bounds it goes. Rice will keep it.
Whoever's guarding Arm is not in a position to help people.
Now comes to Williams. That's out and drives by Allman. Three ball. No good. That's the best look that one so far. He couldn't get it. Britton clears the ball. Hold on. This is the kickback. It's kicked off a couple of different times. Still won't fall. Now the ball loose and finally cleared by McKeever for Houston.
That's great hustle by Rice. Got to get somebody with a pass. They attack the offensive glass real hard. He's got a box out. Just to move
that. That was Belton and Britton. Both having some looks at some putbacks and knew the one could get it to go.